guys. So hopefully you can enjoy my nice little seating arrangement here. It's a little crazy, but today I'm going to be doing yet another video about the Mora Garberg versus the world. And of course, as you guys can see, I'll be rolling in some footage. And as always, guys, please do not forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe before we get into this. So now let's actually get into this. And like I said, I'm gonna be rolling in some use footage here and showing you guys basically how these two are performing. So the first off is the competitor, and that is the Allegheny Knives M38. That is the competitor for this episode. And overall, I actually have to say, and I kind of already knew this because I have some experience with my V1 M38, and I have to say these two are very, very similar. The Mora Garberg and the M38 V2. These knives act almost exactly like each other, and I think you guys can see just how impressive it actually is, this little M38 V2. And it works really, really well at feather sticking, batoning, and fire starting, actually. Now, I decided to forego the notch making because these two, once again, you guys can get an idea here just by these handful of tests that these two are very similar knives. So the performance in notch making is actually very similar, and so to save some time with the whole test footage, I actually decided that I was going to forego the whole notch making, because notch making, it takes a lot of time and it's a lot to roll in for footage. So I'm just doing the fire test, basically, of batoning wood, feather sticking that wood, and then lighting a fire with that wood and some birch bark. And these are all real world tests, as I hope you guys can see that this wood is aspen that I'm picking up off the ground. A lot of this stuff is like just like this piece of wood right here. You know, it's covered in snow. You just hit it off, but it's covered in snow. It's all frozen. None of this stuff is good wood. I'm not bringing this stuff from inside my heated house. So I really like doing these types of tests where I actually take real world wood. This is just aspen. This is a dead aspen tree that I felled around my house, and then I just cut it up into pieces and I let it sit out here outside. It's in no heated environment whatsoever. And I just try and baton it and, you know, go at it and see how well it performs. And so that's the basic premise to this test. And both of these, like I said, they perform very well. And as always, I'm very impressed with this little M38 V2. I will say it has been a very good knife, and it did an excellent job at feather sticking, better than I thought it would. It actually started taking up a lot of wood. You guys could see probably how large those feathers were. That really, really impressed me. And overall, this knife is a very impressive knife. And I have to say that it's naturally a very good knife, because I've tested quite a few knives in this test, this kind of gauntlet test of just knives versus the Garberg. And a lot of them, they end up failing, especially around the fire starting end of things, of throwing hot enough sparks to start real world birch bark. And by the way, just the birch bark is just stuff around my house. I just go grab a handful of birch bark and try and light it on fire. I don't do anything to the birch bark. And I really like this test because we all know that even a small spark would start Vaseline soaked cotton balls, and we're going to carry things like Tinder Quick, wet fire, Vaseline soaked cotton balls. That's what we're going to realistically carry in our survival kits. But I like to test these knives on real world conditions, just saying that these knives can, if you just pick up a piece of birch bark from a tree or rip it off a tree and throw sparks on it, both of these knives will start that birch bark. You don't have to scrape the birch bark into small shavings or do any special modifications. You can just grab it and go. And so naturally, these two knives are really impressive and very similar to each other. So as far as performance goes, I can't really give either an edge, though I will say I like overall the ergonomics better. The ergonomics, and I like to do this once again with winter, full-on winter mittens on, because one, it's comfortable for me to do that, and secondly, it gives a really good platform for, you know, realistic winter survival testing. And so I will say this one has a larger handle than the Garberg, so it is more comfortable to handle with a full-on mitten. That is something that I definitely give this knife. So it definitely is a little bit easier for that. And so I give the overall advantage to this knife, but I will say, price being considered, this one is $150, whereas the Garberg is around $100 to $80. So depending on what your price point is, the Allegheny is the better option, but at the same time, the Mora is a better, or is probably the more affordable option for you and the more realistic option. So overall, if you can't afford it, I would recommend the Allegheny, because the Allegheny is, strictly speaking, the better knife of these two. And all of the performance, this one does outperform the Garberg, not by a substantial margin, but definitely by a noticeable margin. So other than that, the only other downside I will go to for the Allegheny, and you guys have seen it in other videos, is the whole fact that this knife is made out of A2. So that kind of means, or not kind of, but that means ultimately that the rust resistance of this knife is not as high as in other knives. So you do have to keep in mind, and especially in a wintry condition like this, where all this water will turn to, or sorry, all this snow will turn to water. And so you do have to make sure that you keep snow and water, subsequently water, ice, all that type of precipitation off of your blade. And I will say Allegheny has done a good job at giving this knife a nice, tough, durable black traction coating. So you do, most of the knife is protected, but do keep that in mind that you will need to wash this knife and make sure that it does not get water on the actual cutting edge, or it can rust up on you. Whereas with this Garberg, Garberg is not quite as nice, but it also is stainless steel, so you do not have to worry about the rust resistance or anything like that. In this 14C28N steel that they use, I have tested quite a bit on water, and it has been overall pretty good, especially with fresh water. Now, I can't necessarily speak for salt water, but fresh water sources are overall, it handles them just fine. I have no issues, no rusting on fresh water sources. This is a very rust resistant knife. And so it's nice that there is a limited care factor to this knife. So that is definitely an advantage to the Garberg. Of course, as per mentioned, or as I already mentioned, this knife is significantly cheaper as well, but at the same time, you do suffer a little bit in quality and a little bit in performance, because the sheath isn't quite as high quality as the Allegheny, and overall, the ergonomics aren't quite as good as the Allegheny. So overall, this knife is slightly just a little bit like a cut below the Allegheny. Anyways, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this and saw some of the roll-in footage, and hopefully you guys enjoyed this latest installment of Mora Garberg versus the world. Anyways, guys, God bless, and I'm out. What?